Sacred Heart High School welcomes you to the virtual class.
English Kumar Bharti, Standard 10th, Unit 2, Poem Number 1, Animals. Animals by Walt Whitman. Walt Whitman, 1819 to 1892, was an American poet, essayist, and journalist. A humanist, he was a part of transition between transcendentalism and realism, incorporating both views in his works. Whitman is among the most influential poets in the American canon, often called the father of free verse. His work was controversial in its time, particularly his poetry collection, Leaves of Grass, which was described as obscene for its over-sensuality. Let's begin the poem. I think I could turn and live with animals. They are so placid and self-contained. I stand and look at them long and long. Here, placid means calm, peaceful. Contained means keep up control. The poet says that he wants to live in the world of animals. Here, we can say that the poet finds the world of animals better than that of human beings. He further says that he finds animals more peaceful than humans. He says so because animals are not running after worldly things like human beings. They are calm and have no greed for worldly things or any kind of achievements. They are self-contained, means they are happy with life and never interfere in lives of others. Humans have the habit of interfering in lives of others. So poet thinks that animals are better than humans for being calm and not interfering in the matters of others. The poet further says that these are the reasons why he stands still and looks at the animals for a long time. The literary devices in this paragraph is assonance, the use of vowel sound, that is I, think, I, live with animals, I, assonance is repeated. The figure of speech in this stanza is repetition, where the word long is repeated pleasingly. Let's see the next paragraph. They do not sweat and whine about their condition. They do not lie away in the dark and weep for their sins. They do not make me sick discussing their duty to God. Not one is dissatisfied, not one is demented with the mania of owning things. Here, sweat means complaint. Whine means to cry. Sins means wrongdoing. And demented means mad or disturbed. Here, the poet wants to say that, unlike humans, animals don't complain of any misery. They never cry out loud like humans do. They show what they have lost. They never stay awake in the night, crying in repentance for their wrongdoings. This means that animals are different from human beings because they don't show anger or grief if something wrong happens with them. He further says that animals are very truthful because they never boast of their good deeds done in the name of God. He says so because most of the human beings do this. They try to show their good deeds and religiousness to others. They do so in order to gain popularity among their fellows. So the poet thinks that the animals never irritate him by doing such things, just to gain some praise from their fellow people. He feels that the animals are not dissatisfied like humans. They stay happy with whatever they have. They run behind worldly things. They never run behind worldly things. They never try to possess things of comfort or luxury. He says that none of them is mad behind owning worldly things. Here, the figure of speech is metaphor. Sweat and wine refers to the cries and complaints of human beings. Let's see the next paragraph. Not one kneels to another, nor to his kind that lived thousands of years ago. Not one is respectable or unhappy over the whole earth, so they show their relations to me, and I accept them. They bring me tokens of myself, they evince them plainly in their possession. Your kneel means bow down. Evince means show, reveal. Possession means ownership of something. Tokens means qualities. Here, the poet says that he has never seen any animal showing his devotion to anyone by bowing down in front of a person. They never do so even for their ancestors. They do not show devotion towards God like humans do. No one among them is more respectable or important as we have in human society. In human beings, rich people are generally given more importance and are treated with more respect as compared to the poor. But in the society of animals, they never do so. They never give more or less importance to any other animal. Everyone in the animal world is happy. They are not like human beings who find themselves the happiest or the saddest person on the earth. Further, the poet says that animals are more honest in showing their relations with other animals. Here, he wants to say that animals use other animals as their food and they never try to hide this. Whereas humans, being sure that they have nice and friendly relation with others, though the reality is opposite. The poet says that he accepts the fact that animals are true towards showing their relation with other animals. Here, the figure of speech is again metaphor. The inner qualities of humans are referred to as tokens. The next paragraph, and the last one. I wonder where they get those tokens. Did I pass that way huge times ago and negligently drop them? Here, negligently means carelessly. So at last, poet introspects himself and says that from where the animals got those good qualities, he further questions himself that where is his own good qualities gone? Did he leave them or had carelessly lost them somewhere? The qualities that were found in human beings in the past, like innocence, kindness, truthfulness, are now seen in animals. He wonders that humans gave up these qualities and they have been passed on to the animals now. Let's understand the summary of the poem. In the poem Animals, the poet has described his will to become an animal because he thinks animals are far better than human beings. Human beings are greedy and full of jealousy against each other. But animals are calm and self-contained. The animals are happy with what they have. They never complain about miseries and sorrows. On the other hand, human beings complain about their miseries. They give more importance to the rich and strong people, stay restless because of their wrongdoings, and run behind the luxurious things of the world. Whereas, animals are honest about their relations and don't give importance to a particular class. They live a life which is full of honesty and less of greed and jealousy. I hope you understood the poem.